Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been a hot minute since I've done a makeup tutorial. I promised myself that I would use more color this year. This is my first colorful look of 2016. Ooh, ooh. Very proud of myself. This eye makeup look was actually inspired by an artist on Instagram that I found, Alyssa Marie Artistry. So I saw this look and I was like, dang, it's so different than anything I would do. I will link her Instagram down below in the description box if you guys want to go check her out. I'm also going to include items that I got in my IFC Glam bag this month. Also used the new Manny MUA Makeup Geek collaboration palette with this look. If you guys are interested in this makeup look, keep on watching. All right, first we gotta prep the skin. So I'm gonna use this lightweight hydrating cream. This is by Seraphine Botanicals and it's the Carrot and Rose Hydrating Cream. Next, I'm going to prime my skin using the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Oil. And this is the first oil primer that I have ever tried. And I think it's the first of its kind. Moving on to foundation, I'll be using the Makeup Forever HD Stick, and I'm only going to apply this on the cheekbone and under eye area as a highlight. This is a lighter shade than my skin tone, it's 127. I've been using this in that area because it makes it look more hydrated, but if I use it all over my face, I just look kind of oily, so I just use it there. That's been working really well for me. All right, next I'm going to go in with my foundation. I've kind of been mixing foundations lately, so today I'm going to be mixing the new Tarte Rainforest of the Sea foundation and the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation. This is a super tan shade, and because my face is pale, I just mix a couple of drops of this to make this match my skin tone better. You guys can just use whatever you have. You don't have to be like crazy mixing 20 foundations like I am. Where's my beauty blender? Hello? Oh my gosh, put out an SOS. Happening. Where's my beauty
blender? It's on your lap.
It is? So I mix those two foundations together and just apply it earlier. So it looks super tan at first, but that's just because my face is so pale. But once I blend it in, it matches the rest of my body. I'm going to be going in with the Bye Bye Under Eye. This is one of my favorite concealers to kind of conceal basically anything. This concealer is amazing. It's by It Cosmetics, and I'm using the shade Tan. Where you have more of a hollow, I feel like this really does a good job at concealing that. I'm going to be using the Luxie 182 brush, and this is one of the brushes from the JD Weighty 180 collection. I've been loving this to apply it. This concealer is pretty thick, so I just take like the lightest amount and apply it kind of like that in the hollow areas, and then I blend it away. I'm not gonna apply any eyeshadow base today just because, really, because I can't find it at the moment, that's why. No big deal, but if you're wearing this for a long night, you should definitely apply one. I'm gonna go into this new beautiful palette. This is the Manny MUA collaboration with Makeup Geek palette. And I'm gonna be taking this shade, which is Sora. And I'm using the Luxie 231 Small Tapered Blending Brush. And this is gonna just help me blend this color into the upper crease area. This makeup look is gonna be super extreme today, guys. It's not gonna be everyone's cup of tea, but I wanna just try to do something outside of my comfort zone because, you know, I tend to stay in the neutrals. And I just want to make sure that I'm catering to all my color lovers out there. This is a really nice transition shade. So I'm kind of taking it pretty high up just because we're going to be diffusing eyeshadows all over the place. I should have highlighted the brow bone before I put that color down, but I forgot. So I'm just going to go into this bone color. This is from the Too Faced Peanut Butter Palette, super cute. This is the PB&J color, but any like bone light colored eyeshadow will work. I'm just going to highlight with that. Highlight the brow bone, it just overall makes the eyeshadow look a lot cleaner. Next, I'm going to pick up these two shades and just mix them together. There goes my phone. And apply them in the outer crease just to deepen it up. I know it looks like every other makeup tutorial right now, but it's gonna take a turn in a second, you'll see. I mean, you probably already saw in the intro, so you already know. I'm using a Smith 230 brush. This is one of my favorite blending brushes. I'm gonna apply most of the product on the outer corner, and then whatever's left over, just kind of blend it into the inner corner. I'm gonna go back with the Luxie brush and blend out those edges. Blend your edges. Okay, pues. Next, we're gonna take the ColourPop gel liner. This is in the shade Maybe. It's green. This is right here. I'm gonna use this as a light base because we're about to put neon green on our lids. Oh man, I'm getting crazy today, guys. Like, who is this person using this colored eyeshadow? New year, new me. So next, I'm gonna be using the Radioactive Stack by Melt Cosmetics. It doesn't scream Desi, but I gotta do new things. I gotta make moves. I'm gonna be using this green color. Oh shit, this is called, I don't know, Xenon, this green. Pack this on carefully. So next I'm picking up Neon from the Melt Cosmetics stack and I'm gonna pack that in the inner corner of my eye as a highlight using the 237 Detailed Shader Brush by Zoeva. Concentrating most of it on the inner corner and then blending it up into the green and then the edges around the tear duct. Thing with neon colors is they do have some fallout. Next, I'm gonna be picking up Radioactive, which is this neon pink shade with a Zoeva 224 brush. Start building this lower lash line up out in this outer corner area. I like to use this brush because it's super soft and gentle for the under eye. It doesn't distribute like a crap load of product, so it's good to build like a smoky effect around the eye. And I'm just gonna connect this to the outer corner over here. Before I continue the under eye area, I forgot to apply more concealer just because I had so much fallout. So I'm just gonna carefully go in and apply my NARS Creamy Concealer in Ginger. I'm just gonna kind of put it right here in this triangle area. Once again, it's like the search for the beauty blender. Where does this beauty blender keep going? It literally just wants to ruin my life, this beauty blender. Blend that all in. Being really careful not to mess up what we did on the lower lash line here. Set that all with the Laura Mercier translucent powder and just lightly dip my beauty blender inside of this. I like to take most of the powder and apply it here first and then work my way up. That way, once I get to the under eye area, I'm not applying too much powder and it doesn't look too cakey. Go into the orange, this color right here. So I'm gonna pack the orange color a little bit more in this inner part of my eye. Going into the yellow cream color by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I'm just gonna apply that to the waterline. apply mascara. This is the Tartist Tarte Mascara. It's their new one. The packaging is everything. And then I'm going to apply... Look at my hand right now. This is crazy.
Get a makeup remover wipe.
I mean, it is what it is, Steven. I don't know.
All right. You do.
Okay, so I'm going to apply the Queen Bee Lashes by Coco Lashes, and I'll be right back. This is the eye look complete. We're just going to go ahead and finish off the rest of the face. I'm using MAC Give Me Sun, of course, and my MAC 135 brush. Everyone always asks me, 135. 135. It's my favorite to bronze the whole face because it's just perfect. It's super fluffy. Gives you like a nice all over bronze instead of just like a denser brush would give you more of like a pinpoint bronze. I like to apply that on the hollows of the face and the perimeter of the hairline. And whatever's left over on the brush after you've applied, I just kind of lightly go over the rest of the face and blend it all together. All right, now it's time for the highlighter. It's my favorite part, of course. I'll be using the new Tarte highlighter. This is the Skin Twinkle Trio. This one is by far my favorite, which is the far left in the palette. But I do like to mix these two. I don't really care for the center color. I just like the outside colors. You like that? Give it to me. Put some of that on the tip of my nose. All right, now it's time for blush. I'll be using the Bella Pierre Cosmetics Mineral Blush. This is in the shade Desert Rose. It's just a really pigmented, rosy blush. I like to give a little smile. Pop it on the cheeks. All right, so for my lip liner, I will be using the Tartist lip liner in the shade Totes. Look how crooked my Cupid bows are. Whoa! So for the lip color, I'll be using Dose of Colors liquid lipstick in Pinky Promise. Nail color in this video is Essie Hubby for Dessert. And over top of that, I have the Perfect Formula Pink Gel Top Coat. And this is just gonna protect your polish to make sure it lasts a little bit longer. All right, guys, so that is it for this makeup tutorial. I really hope that you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you guys aren't subscribed to my vlog channel, I do have a vlog channel with my husband, Stephen Perkins. I will put a link to it right over here. We just uploaded a new vlog. It was our trip to Hawaii with Tarte Cosmetics. So I really hope that you guys enjoy watching that video, and I'll see you guys next time. Why'd I do that? Oh, God. I'm gonna wake, 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 wake. I caked on my makeup. I'm not gonna lie. It's too hard to breathe. Ooh, girl. I'm a grown ass woman. Ah! I shouldn't really be promoting drinking though. Ooh! It's probably Katie. Missing me.
Oh, shit. The fuck?
Yep.